Tātanīn dī wūgīt nāngtān, dā gyānāq nī gyūpāg nāngtān kāngdāng kāng yin nā cāngmāgam jōnī dā tāni gyākaram phāqbī yarāt tāg yon rī. Gyākaram phāqbī yirgī yāng sō huār nālīn chī lopchā chīmū. Huār nālīn chī lopchā chīmū pārchīr dā tīrīb jī nī pchīgnī bā yarmar zīg bār yin cārī. Dā tī vār dā tāg zāng nāna hāchāng chakshū chīwā gān tāni shār shukur lopchā dā nī nāng tāni mū māngbō zī dā xūr kion shī yon rī. Hui na jana kawanda shi na ta tang shan zong kong yin na tani jana jagar ka huar nalan chik zikla kang tani ta lama tsutum zong si ji kong tarik tani tani tsadma mdo wamar tsawa shi rin ta te la suk ba ga hujung mungu zik da tani lo zhong shi tani ta mara yong e tani tambar pen zhi dedang jawa ka jana ka ta yi jin zi ji zgo re Deyang tarik dehnun zimba, hachang kweba chenpo re. Kung yang huar nalin chaga zilak kanga songa loma lop chiga ranga teni dana. Teni chu mambu, tam mara gyanaga yong di teni tamba vzhugya yarmar tari toga kunga shikshiga nangay dana. Toga ta gyanaga tambar peren re zong re. Ta kung namba nika ga zu shisa zika teni gyanagam kweba mongo gyagar ga chun de teni тога мара нанжен ичрэнгодан та тога чуг тэни та дянак хориг чэмботэ латарэ тарпир шинэрэ.
Now the source for both Tibetan and Chinese Buddhist traditions is ancient India, and specifically the Nalanda Institution for Buddhist Studies or the Nalanda University. And so according to Tibetan history, this is a place where the greatest masters of the tradition all studied, and including Guru Rinpoche and the great masters, and then also according to Chinese history, this is the place where the great masters of Chinese Buddhism also began and brought that knowledge back into China. So the Nalanda University was established in the 5th century, and it continued until the 12th century, some 700 years. During that time, masters such as Xuanzang, who lived during the Tang Dynasty, went to Nalanda and brought his knowledge back to China, translated the texts into Chinese. Also Shila Bhadra, who was a pandit at Nalanda, was one of the masters that the famous translator from China, Yi Jin, studied under. This Yi Jin also went to Nalanda, received his instructions from the Shila Bhadra master, and then became a great scholar in the Madhyamaka philosophy, in the philosophy of Pramana, logic, of Abhidharma, metaphysics, of Madhyamika Karika, and other great important crucial texts. And it's said that he brought some 400 volumes back to China and translated them all from Sanskrit into Chinese. And so these are two of the great masters who brought a lot of the Buddhist tradition into China from India.